Okay, in this video, I'm going to show you the dispatching board and the different views you can look to have. The dispatch board button starts right here, and it does open up in a separate screen. A lot of times my customers have this screen on a second monitor or up on a monitor where everyone in the office can see. Okay, so this will show you the work for the day, where everyone's going. If your technician isn't showing up on this board, you come up here to select technicians and decide which technicians you want to show up on your board here. All right. You can go to your previous day or your next day right on the screen here. If you had open work orders, you would be able to drag and drop them around by clicking on and moving them around. Clicking on right here, you can see how it goes to a little four-way arrow. That means you can click on it and drag and drop it, the work order, around. This is the day view. You can also look at the week view, and then you'd be able to see the work orders that you have here. So you'd be able to click on it, and it'll zoom into that specific day. This is the schedule view here, okay? So it's our scheduling view. We can see where everybody is, what the status is. You can also look in your list view, and in the list view, you can show your technicians here on the side and also the work orders here. So you can see scheduled work orders, so only your service agreement work orders, or you can see your dispatch work orders, or all. Okay. So this is the list view here, and it gives you kind of a, you know, where the status. You can quickly go in and, you know, edit the problem, or, you know, put this on hold, or whatever, you know, set the status for these work orders. You can also go in and mass set the status for these work orders if you want to. Okay, so they have the schedule and list view, and then we also have the map. What the map does is it shows us our work orders on the map, where are our work orders, and where's our technicians. Okay, so here's my tech, and here are my different work orders, and if I click on any of these, of course, it will show me what work orders are there, and if I click on one of those, it'll show me the detail of the work order, and this is something you set up in your settings. All right, I can also see the techs. So it'll show me where my technicians are. Notice that it will show you when the last time they checked into the system was. So I have it checking in every 20 minutes. So it'll check in again at 4:28. It'll show you what direction they're heading. It'll show you what their speed is and what the reason for that check-in was. So if I had checked into a job, it would say, you know, or checked into a work order, it would say work order check-in there. Okay. This is Google Maps here, as you notice, so you can zoom in easily, zoom in easily here. You can click and drag around your map, so you can move things around pretty easily there to see what else is going on. You can also look at it at this, you know, the satellite view or the hybrid view as well. Okay, so it's what you're used to in using Google Maps. All right. Most of my clients do. Once we, you know, we can look at the map view every once in a while, but they like to be in the list view and looking at it as a schedule. This is how most of my clients have it set up, so that they can see where everyone is and, if you know, what the job status is very easily. If this job's grayed out because it's completed. If it had not been picked up yet, it would be yellow. If it was in route, it would be blue. Or if it was picked up but not started, it would be blue. And then if it was started, it would be green. And if it was past due, it would be red. Okay. So that's just a little bit of, you know, going through the different ways that you can look at your dispatch board.